quiet for the morning hours so far on this Sunday, but can't really say that for the northern part of the state. Heavy rain, lots of lightning, even one lone severe thunderstorm warning north of Grenada. This could possibly clip our north and eastern counties from Holmes over towards Atala later this morning. I do expect a couple of thunderstorms to roll through the area as well this afternoon and tonight, one or two of which could be a little bit gusty, providing not only torrential downpours, but gusts up to around 40 to 60 miles an hour. Very brief period, but if you recall back on Friday with those isolated thunderstorms that created very strong gusts for about 30 to 45 minutes, that's something that we could expect with these storms later today. Front arrives today. This is going to stall down towards the coastline later this afternoon, bringing cooler, drier air back behind it. But we have one more day of triple-digit heat before we finally see that big break in our forecast. Outside around 7 o'clock this morning in the mid to upper 70s, low 80s, we have widespread sunshine with a couple of clouds. Those clouds will increase going through the day, and then the rain and storms start to develop mainly after 12, 1 o'clock today, but for the most part after 3. Our temperatures are expected to range anywhere between 100 to 104 with the Jackson Metro around 102. So your outlook for today brings those rain and storms into the picture by the early parts of the afternoon. A lot of that thunderstorm activity really is going to be east of 55, but we could have a couple of afternoon pop-ups over towards our river counties. For the river counties per se, it's going to be more so into the overnight hours with our next batch of rain and storms. That should clear out shortly after sunrise. And then by the afternoon hours tomorrow, I think this is really going to be south and east of the Natchez Trace Parkway to where we will see the best chance of rain and storms. So we have a couple more days where we could have rain. I don't think a lot of people are complaining. And with that front, again, it's going to drop the temperatures from 102 today to 94 for tomorrow. All right, update on the tropics as of the 7 o'clock advisory. We have Tropical Depression number 10. This is expected to become Tropical Storm Idalia later today, if not tonight, and will be making its way into the southern part of the Gulf of Mexico over the next 24 hours. One thing that we are watching with this system is the possibility of rapid intensification because of these bathwater type sea surface temperatures. We're in the mid to upper 80s when it comes to sea surface temperatures. That's very warm, lots of energy for this system to absorb, but we're also watching some shear in the Gulf of Mexico, which will help inhibit growth with these storms. A lot of models are trending strengthening to hurricane status before landfall. The 7 o'clock update does bring it to a Category 1 storm by Tuesday afternoon with a landfall in between Port St. Joe and Gainesville, Florida, by around Wednesday morning before downgrading to tropical storm status over towards Augusta, Georgia by Thursday morning. Again, this is an initial model. Once this becomes a tropical storm and moves into the Gulf of Mexico, I think we're going to have a lot more information on exactly what we can expect with this, the exact landfall, and whether it goes over towards Port St. Joe or over towards the Big Bend area. But one thing, if you have friends and family over in this area from the Panhandle to the northern part of the peninsula, you really have to take into consideration not only rip current storm surge, but also the possibility of this rapidly intensifying. A lot of models right now are trying to push this more towards a Category 2, if not a major hurricane status. We're keeping this at a Category 1, but if these models continue, I do expect this to be showing signs of rapid intensification later today, if not tomorrow, when it comes to our outlooks. Your 7-day forecast drops the temperatures here at home into the upper 60s, low 70s in the morning, mid to low 90s in the afternoon. With what will be Idalia, we're going to be on the western side, so we're not looking at much impacts with this. However, because we're on the western side, we could get some cooler, drier air in place, which will provide widespread sunshine for the end of the week.